Hi, my name is Amandeep. I'm a master's in computer application from Punjabi University, Patiala. I have done a diploma in business fluency and communication skills from U Fairfield EduTech. I'm a trained spoken English teacher since past 10 years. I've been taking maths, computer, and English classes of grade 1 to 10 of ICSE board, CBSE board, and Australian board. So this is my brief introduction, and let's start with the topic now. The topic I'm taking is parts of speech. It is a very basic grammar topic, and I will let you know how to identify the parts, where various parts of speech in a sentence. Parts of speech. Basically, there are 8 parts of speech: noun, verb, pronoun, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, interjection. So very first part of speech I'm taking is noun. Noun is a naming word. Anything that has a name is a noun. It can be the name of a person, a place, a thing, a feeling, an idea. So basically, it is the name of a thing. For example, Rajni has a big house. Here, Rajni is a name of a person. So it is a noun. She has a big house. House is the name of a thing. It is a noun. She is going to Mumbai. Mumbai is the place of name of a place. So it is a noun. She loves Ramesh. Love is a feeling. So it is a noun. The example I've taken here are, we bought a new house. Here, house is the name of a thing. It is a noun. Ramesh owns a car. Here, Ramesh is the name of a person. So Ramesh is a noun. Owns a car. A car is the name of a thing. And it is also a noun. Next is the pronoun. Pronoun basically are the noun replaces a word that takes the place of a noun in a sentence. For example, Veronica is very beautiful. So when we have to write another word for the same person, we will not write the name again. What we will do is we will identify that noun in the sentence. Then we can replace that noun with the equivalent gender of the person in that. Veronica is very beautiful. She lives in Mumbai. Here she represents Veronica. Next is adjective. Adjective is anything that describes, modify, or give more information about a noun or pronoun. Adjective do not qualify any other part of speech. Basically, adjective gives us more information about what a noun or pronoun is. For example, little girl has a red hat. Here, hat is a noun. What kind of hat? Red hat. Red is giving us more information about the kind of hat. So red here is basically an adjective that is identifying the color of the hat. Next is verb. Verb is basically, what we understand from verb is that it is an action state, but basically it is not about action. It is about verb is also action, thinking, feeling, and a state. Action is anything that is in action, anything that is moving, that has some action, is a verb. Any feeling is also a verb. For example, she is going to school. Here, going is a verb. We practically understand that going is something, a kind of movement, that is a kind of action. So here, going is a verb. But how will you identify a verb in a sentence where we specify? Let's take an example. Rita loves her son. So do you, can you identify the verb here? Rita loves her son. Love is a feeling. It is a feeling or thinking. So here, love is a verb. And another way to identify a verb in a sentence is the state of being. Be is always used as verb. The various form of be is in a present form and past form is MR, was and were. They are always a verb. Next is adverb. Adverb, similar to adjective, adverb is a word that adds more information about the place, time, manner, cause, or degree to a verb. Adverb always identify a verb, adjective, or adverb. There is no another part of speech which an adverb will qualify. So basically, it gives us more information about what sort of what is it gives us more and more information about the verb. For example, I ate my lunch. Here, lunch is a verb. Ate is the verb. How did you eat your lunch? I ate my lunch quickly. So ate is a verb here because it is action. And how this action has happened? It happened quickly. So I ate my lunch quickly. Quickly is an adverb here. Next is preposition. Preposition is, as the word show, preposition, anything which is positioned before a noun or a pronoun is called preposition. It gives us kind of information about where something is and when something happened. For example, let's take an example. The owl is on the box. The owl is on the box. Where the owl is on? So here, on is a preposition. The owl is under the box. Where the owl is, it is under the box. So here, under is a preposition. One more example I'm taking here, which is not being specified, is the phone is on the table besides you. Where is phone? On the table. On is a preposition here. Where this you is also a pronoun, and it is telling the exact location of the phone. It is on the table is a preposition. Beside you is also a preposition. Next is conjunction. Conjunction is basically, they are known as joining words. They join two words, two idea, phrases, and they show how the two sentences are being connected. Like, I was tired, but still finished it. I was tired, but still finished it. We can bifurcate this sentence into two sentences. I was tired is one sentence. I still finished is another sentence. But this word but has joined these two sentences, and we had just made one word. I was tired, but still finished it. I have a car and a scooter. Here, and is a conjunction because it is joining two different sentences. Last is interjection, word or phrase that expresses strong emotion and feeling is interjection. It basically ends with an exclamation mark, and it is very easy to recognize. Is the basic thing, the basic of interjection is it stresses more on the feeling and on the sudden reaction. Ouch, hey, wow, I passed my math exam. Here, wow is an interjection. So according to some authors, articles are also parts of speech, but basically articles are adjective. For example, I take a simple sentence. I have a book. Book is a noun. How many books do I have? I have a book, one book. So anything that gives more information about a noun is always an adjective. So hence, a lot of authors are not including articles into these parts of it because according to them, all the articles are always an adjective. Thank you.